Welcome to rSlash Choosing Beggars, where people threaten to kill themselves if they don't get free stuff.
Hello, Blank. I know we went on a date a while ago now, but I'd like to explain why I haven't messaged you. I feel like you could have made the date much better. Here's a few reasons why. I apologize if I offend you. If you lost some weight, you would look incredible, maybe about a stone or so. You are very pale. I know you aren't a fan of the sun, but a bit of fake tan won't hurt. You have quite big boobs, so you should show off your cleavage more. I think you need to wear clothes that suit your figure and maybe update your style slightly, just so I'm not embarrassed to be seen with you. You need to dye your hair a normal color and add extensions. Longer hair is much more attractive. You need to look more natural. Stop wearing makeup. Just make yourself look decent, but don't overkill it. Your lips have gone down, so you should think of getting more filler. I know you said you regretted it, but filler would make you sexier. You need so much more confidence. Confidence is sexy. The fact you take things slow makes you look like a prude. I didn't get a kiss, which messed with my ego. Be more sensitive to others' feelings. When we had food, I know you got a salad, but having a full fat Coke is more calories you don't really need. You need to keep your past to a minimum. I don't care about it and what you went through. Get a sense of humor. You didn't laugh at a single one of my jokes. You just seemed a bit stuck up. Sort your personality out. You made me feel bad when you offered to pay. It's like you thought I didn't have enough money after telling you how much is in my account. You didn't compliment me once. If you take these on board, I might consider another date. I will give you a month and get back in touch to see if you have made a difference. Good day to you, Blink. And to all my female viewers out there, good news, ladies. I hear this guy is still single. I work at a toy store in Canada and get this stuff all the time. But this is the first time someone demanded a manager over it in the years I've worked here, so here you go. Woman comes in with two items and the subtotal is in the area that she has. I then apply taxes by pressing total and she balks.
I had the right amount before taxes, I swear.
She laughs while sighing and digging through her purse.
Sorry, this is going to take a while.
That's perfectly all right. I call someone to cash too, so we have all the time in the world. After she produces about half of her purse, she manages to get within $3 of the total and sighs.
$3 short. Geez, sorry, this doesn't usually happen.
Sorry to hear it. I'll hold the items for you until close if you want to come back.
What? You can't just knock $3 off of it?
She actually turns from being sad and embarrassed with a smile to instantly angry and tilting her head at me like I'm stupid. No, you can't really negotiate with store prices. This isn't the same as Facebook or eBay or places like that. I frown.
People have literally done this for me at Walmart for like $10 though. Really? Over $3? I can't have my stuff.
She is getting louder at this point and laughing angrily while looking over to other customers for people who agree. No one is. I can hold our store items for you to purchase when you have the money for them. I pull the items away.
Ugh, look, just let me talk to the manager. They always give me deals. It's not okay that I'm being embarrassed like this over $3.
I call my manager. My manager tells her we can hold the items, but we're not going to keep doing this. Woman leaves with a scowl after claiming we're overpriced. Manager lets me know we did it once for her when her kid was with her because she wouldn't shut up about how she was going to get such a nice toy, but now she can't.
I like how she was like, sorry, this doesn't usually happen. And then she goes into all these other examples of how this has happened many times before.
This is clearly a scam that she runs to try and knock a few bucks off the price every time she tries to buy something.
Called to see if they had a military discount, and yes, they do. 5%. They can't even do 10%? Glad my service means nothing to these people. 1 star.
This choosing beggar is getting preferential treatment, and because it isn't preferential enough, he's giving them 1 star? I don't know what company he's reviewing, but now I want to go give them my business to support these people because this is totally unfair.
Story time. I got free hotcakes with any purchase of a breakfast sandwich. Guy starts begging at McDonald's for money to get something to eat. I offer him all the hotcakes. He goes,
nah, I'm okay, thanks.
Guess he wasn't that hungry. I guess him wearing beets should have been the first clue.
Hello, is the PC you are selling still available?
Yep, the asking price is $500. I could negotiate a little though.
I have $100. Is that enough? I could give you Fortnite account if you want. Please, please, please.
I could do $450 and I don't play Fortnite, lol.
F you then, I'll cut my wrist and think of your family tonight.
Interesting negotiating strategy. Either cut your prices or I cut my wrists?
So I rent an apartment with a roommate. She makes 2 times more money than I do. So I thought it would be fair if she paid more rent than me since she'll have more money left over. What's y'all's opinions?
Is this a serious question?
I feel we should pay the same percentage of our checks.
I don't know who this Choosing Beggars roommate is, but I really hope she starts using Reddit because I have a sneaking suspicion that she has some awesome stories to tell.
Hey, I saw your ad for the controller. It's brand new, right?
Yep, it's brand new.
Nice. I was wondering if you could lower the price just a little. It's my birthday this week, smiley face.
It's brand new, and I'm only asking for $25.
Yes, but it's my birthday. Please.
I'm sorry, but just because it's your birthday, I'm not just going to drop the price. And like I said, it's already a good amount cheaper than the original price.
Dude, please, can you just drop it to like $10?
Laughing my butt off. Yeah, of course.
For real?
Yep.
Nice. So can you ship it over?
No problem. Do you also want me to add the Xbox One to go with it for $10 more?
Holy cow, really? Oh, flip you, you bag of baguettes. KYS, middle finger.
That actually reminds me, you guys have missed dozens of my birthdays, but you can make it up to me right now by simply subscribing to my channel.
Hey Blank, long time no talk.
So I'm in Blank for the long weekend and I was wondering if I could borrow your car.
Hey man, how are you? Yeah, I'm going out on Sunday, so I'll be using my car then to go and see my family. I can lend it to you any other day, is that okay?
Oh, I was actually thinking about right now.
What? Look at the time, man.
Come on, Blank. I asked Blank and Blank and they both said no to me.
I'm sorry, but I can't, man. You're lucky I was even awake to answer your text, let alone hand you my keys.
But you let me last time.
Dude, I let you have my car last time because I actually could. What do you even need it for flip's sake?
I have an important meeting.
At 11:30? Are you serious?
This is such BS, Blank. You said you had my back whenever you need something, bro. So much for that.
That was before you moved to Blank and basically only spoke to me when you wanted to borrow something.
Okay, butthole. I'm coming over to yours right now. Or you get up and drive out to me on the corner of Blank and Blank and give me your flipping keys.
You still haven't flipping told me what you want it for. And you can flip right off if you're thinking I'm wasting any more of my energy on you.
I'm gonna drive to your mom's and flip her. I'm coming over there, flip face. I don't give a flip. You're letting me borrow the VL.
Yeah, how are you going to get here then? By car? Oh, wait, you don't flip and have one. Good luck. I moved house since you went to Blank, butthole. Maybe if you were actually my friend instead of a leech, you would have known that.
Flip you.
Wait, corner of Blank and Blank is that girl's place, right? Your girlfriend is going to love hearing about how you've been cheating on her again.
Flip you, it's not true.
So I'm going to ask the obvious question here. If he was with his mistress, why didn't his mistress drive him home? Considering how selfish choosing beggars tend to be, I'm gonna guess that his performance wasn't quite what she was hoping for, and she told him to walk home.
Hi, I love your cosplays. You should cosplay Megumi.
Thank you, but sorry, I don't take cosplay requests.
Why?
Cosplay is expensive. I can't just do every cosplay someone requests. I cosplay characters based on who I personally love.
But you're a cosplayer.
I'm aware of that.
Huh? So why don't you cosplay Megumi?
I already said I don't take cosplay requests.
You're a cosplayer. Do your job. You do cosplay when we ask for it. You cosplay others. Why not Megumi?
It's a hobby, and I cosplay who I want to cosplay. Are you trying to say you're gonna pay for the whole costume to try and convince me to cosplay her?
No, WTF, why do I pay? You're a cosplayer, so do your job and do the cosplay, jerk.
So you want me to spend my hard-earned money plus hours of time on creating a cosplay of a character I don't even care for just for you?
You already cosplay, so what's the problem? Just do your job and cosplay her. You can post it on your Instagram too.
Listen, lady, I don't know why you're making this so difficult. All I want to do is imagine you as my waifu so I can play with my little Wing Wong. Honestly, is that really too much to ask?
Hey Abs, it's Cassie. I spoke to you a couple of weeks ago regarding a machine. Have you built it yet?
Hey Cass, I sent the plans over after we spoke. You said you wanted to run them past your boss and you'll get back to me.
I didn't hear anything back, so I haven't ordered the materials. Oh, you said at the time you can squeeze us in, but it would be 2 weeks? It's been 2 weeks and we're under the assumption that we'll be accepting delivery this week.
You are correct, ma'am, but I also said if you were to book that day, you were to have it in 2 weeks, but you said you'll get back to me. I assumed within a couple of days, but I haven't heard anything from you in 2 weeks. Unfortunately, Cassie, also there's a deposit required. We don't have that either.
No, no, no. You said 2 weeks. OMG, my boss is going to kill me. What do we do now?
Well, you didn't get back to me, Cass. I can't just not take on any work on the hope that you'll maybe call me back. Also, there's a couple of $1,000 in materials we can't just front up on a maybe. Sorry, bud.
Arg! So frustrating! Well, how long have I put the order in now?
About 2 weeks.
No, we need it by this Friday. We've already informed our client. He's coming from across state. Please.
Sorry, Cassie. I can't just cancel the current jobs. I've got deadlines on those and they've paid in full, so it's blatant bad business to jerk them around.
OMG, OMG, OMG. What do I tell my boss? I'm screwed. It's your fault. Arg. You need to do it by Friday. Make up some excuse to the other guys, maybe?
No, hon. You walk into your boss's office and you own it. You say you messed up and didn't confirm the order. Now they're too busy to build it by Friday. FYI, the other guys are a larger contract. So there.
I'll get back to you. You know, it was an honest mistake. You could accommodate me.
I could also accommodate a deposit. EFT details are on the invoice.
Funny. I give this business 1 star. I didn't pay them a deposit or actually give them an order, and for some reason they never built my machine. The audacity of this company. They are never having my business again, even though they never actually had my business in the first place.
Not sure if this fits in Choosingbeggars. I was sitting at a table at my local coffee shop, drinking coffee, using my laptop, earbuds in. I feel a tap on my shoulder and I look up to find a 30-something couple staring at me. I take an earbud out and say, "Yes?" To which the woman replies,
"Hi, can we sit here, please?"
I reply, "Oh, sure," and try to slide myself and my stuff over as far as I can. The table is built for two, but you can fit three if you try. The couple sets their belongings on the floor. A minute or so goes by and I feel a tap on my shoulder again. The conversation went as such, "Yes?"
"We're going to sit down now."
Lattes in hand. "Alrighty."
"And you're moving."
"No."
"You said we can sit here."
"Sit with me, I thought you meant." The man gives an annoying exhale laugh.
"There is not enough room for three here."
"You can sit with me if you'd like, or you can find somewhere else to sit. I don't know."
"There's nowhere else to sit. We got our coffees for here because you were giving us your table."
"I don't know, guys. You can sit here with me if you'd like. Up to you." I put my earbuds back in. I go back to what I was doing. Look up 30 seconds later and they're still staring at me. 3 minutes or so later and they're across the room staring at me talking to each other, bags and lattes in hand. 5 minutes later and they're sitting at a newly vacated table. I leave probably 15 minutes later, and as I pass their table, the woman tells me to
"have a very nice rest of the day, sir."
It seems sarcastic.
It would have been awesome if when the couple found that other table, if Opie had come up to the table and been like, oh, cool, thanks for saving me a seat, and just sat down.
That was rSlash Choosing Beggars, and if you want to help me out, please like this video and subscribe down below.